Hello, and welcome to another edition of the eCW podcast. I'm your host, Brian Saal. And as we're all aware, the opioid epidemic continues to wreak havoc across the nation. With me today is Deb Wade from eCW, and we're going to be talking about a way that eClinicalWorks can help providers prescribe opioids in a responsible and compassionate manner. Deb, thanks so much for being with us today.
You're very welcome. Thanks for having me.
Deb, I specifically want to talk about PDMP, which, as we all know, is Prescription Drug Management Program. And I think a lot of people already know about it, possibly have used it. But could you give us a little more in-depth insight into what PDMP is and what it does?
Yes, absolutely. So PDMP stands for Prescription Drug Monitoring Program. It is really all about monitoring the prescriptions that your patients are on, specifically the controlled substances. And in some states, they've added extra things in like gabapentin or cannabinoids. But pharmacists actually report the data when they dispense these controlled prescriptions to their patients. And the PDMP functionality within eClinicalWorks allows our providers to check the PDMP report before they prescribe a controlled substance to their patient. So that way they know exactly what the patient is on and we can safely decide whether or not that patient needs a narcotic.
So they're getting the data from drugstores rather than, say, from insurance companies.
Exactly, yes. So anything that a pharmacist hands out, whether it's cash or from the insurance company, the dispensation, where basically the action of the pharmacist handing the medication to the patient, is what prompts the pharmacist to enter that information into the PDMP program.
Are all states in the country involved in this program?
Almost everybody, but not quite yet. We do have some new federal laws in place where they will be in place fairly soon. But as of right now, I believe every state has at least something, but not everybody's on the network. New York isn't part of the network yet. Missouri is still county by county.
New York is kind of surprising. So, Deb, can a practice choose which one of these vendors they want to use?
Yep, a new customer can select either Apris or Logicoy as long as their state is one of the states that Logicoy supports. Currently, Logicoy supports Washington State, Utah, Nebraska, and Maryland.
Okay. Now, as we mentioned, PDMP has been around for a couple of years now. Has there been any enhancements to PDMP within eCW?
There actually have been a few really nice enhancements. One big thing that we've put in, which is supportable for any state that or any provider that has NARCS care. We have a batch job now that'll run on a nightly basis to capture the basic scores and place them right on the progress note.
Oh, wow.
Now, this doesn't count as an actual click. It doesn't count you actually checking the report, but it really allows the provider to potentially avoid awkward conversations with their patients if, say, you might have a drug seeker on their hands or a patient with just a lot of controlled substances that maybe weren't provided by external RX history because that's not fully inclusive. And it will allow them to look at the score, notice if their patient might not be in a good situation to get narcotics so they can steer the conversation towards other pain management products.
And so then if they did decide they were going to prescribe an opioid, they would go to PDMP itself and do the click there. So that would be reported. Is that sort of the workflow?
Yes, absolutely. So you will actually need to click on the button to read it, but at least you can get a glimpse of that score before you read it. So that way, if you have awkward conversations that might be on the rise, you could avoid that.
Sure. What about reporting and logs?
Yes. So we do actually report and log all of these transactions where we're pulling the data in automatically. So that way, you know what is what. The state won't have those logs because, again, this doesn't count as an actual check, but you'll definitely be able to see the difference in the logs on which ones were actual checks versus just the scores pulling in, because you'll see score showing up in the logs when these are pulled each night. So that way you could be able to filter out those requests in the event that you needed to compare your eClinicalWorks report to the state report to get that truth between the two.
One of the more exciting pieces of information that came up when we were discussing this a little while ago was the fact that PDMP is now available in Puerto Rico. Is that the case?
Yes, it is very exciting for our Puerto Rico customers, and it's fully funded, which means it's free to our Puerto Rico customers as well.
Even better.
Yes, absolutely. It's a huge money saver for some of our larger practices.
Just to wrap this up in one last question, and it's really surrounding multiple states. So I live in Massachusetts, and I can, in the course of a couple of hours, you know, hit three or four or five different states if I'm a drug seeker. How do practices deal with these multiple state requests or multiple state issues?
Absolutely. All you would really need to do, and right now this only works with APRIS at the time, just reach out to them directly through their dedicated email address and send over your web service credentials if you already have them, your practice name, the state you consider to be your home state, and then the list of other states that you'd like to see within that data. Once the integrations are approved by those states, as you do checks for your patients, you'll see those states starting to show up in those results.
That's fantastic. That really covers a lot of bases, I think.
It absolutely does. And it's huge and really, really necessary to be able to do this right.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, Deb, thank you so much for being with us today. You did shine some light on a very, very important topic that's, again, facing the entire nation. I want to thank you for watching the video, everyone. And if you're interested in more eClinicalWorks podcasts, you can find them at my.eClinicalWorks. YouTube, and iTunes. Thanks for joining us today, and have a wonderful, wonderful day.